This was one of the cylindrical mallets, the Liptis or maple mallets, where the handle was too small and I ended up having to go with some chunkier stock because this wasn't enough to hide the mortise, lock around the mortise. So I'm going to use this. I'm going to try to turn a new handle for my cross peen hammer out of this and see if I can't just repurpose this and keep from being wasteful. Now this hammer, I got this from a blacksmith friend of mine, and I don't know where he got it from, but I have a feeling that it's a handmade hammer. This is very imprecise in here. So this is the cross section of the hammer like this, and where the handle hole was drifted through. I mean, it's going to be great because it's going to lock like gangbusters, but it's going to be also a trick for me to pass the handle through. The handle can't be any wider than this point right here, that inside halfway point. So when I get it up, then I want to lock this part into here and then leave enough sticking out of the top that I can cut off, but I also want to slice down into it where I can drive some hardwood wedges in, and then a steel locking wedge. So it's going to be just a little bit of a trick to get it, and it's going to be a lot of trial and error. But I really love this hammer, and so it's worth it to me. And I really didn't like that other store-bought handle that I had put on it. When I got this from him, he just gave me this. And I'd put a couple of those hickory handles on it over the years, but they kept breaking and getting spongy. And so I think this Liptis one, especially this curly piece of Liptis, should really do the trick. So let me see what I can do with this. And when I turn these handles for my metalwork, I like to turn this node on them and then shape the rest of it down into the hammer handle. The same guy that gave me that other handle, he actually made this from scratch. It's super hard steel. But I like to have a little node on my metalworking hammer, so if I'm tapping something like this, I have a place to lock my index finger around, and it's a pretty traditional technique for hammer handles. Okay, so I gotta make a little adjustment on this end here so I don't crack it. I've gotta wallow this out a little bit first, and then I'll start turning it. So like I said, I'd like to turn a maximum spot somewhere right in here, so it allows me to scoop back, and then this tenon that was for the other one will be this part that enters into it. But I need to move back a little bit so I have a smooth transition to come into that tenon. So it's probably going to be right here. I'll just start turning and just kind of see where it needs to be. And that will still be a plenty long enough handle for me to have a new handle for that cross peen hammer. Yeah, so that'll probably be about where the head will lie on the handle right there, and that's good. Okay, let's see what I can do here. Ah, broken, tearing hunks off. Don't be a maniac. That curly piece, so I'm cutting, there's all that reversing grain, so it's probably just, I'll be able to sand that out, I think. That's better. Yeah, that'll sand out. I don't want it that sharp anyway. So, you know, I don't think I'm gonna, yeah, I guess I need to sand this first because this is gonna get so far down there that, yeah, I have to sand it first. I'm gonna clip this off real quick though, while I've got it right here. So I'm just gonna use this pattern maker's rasp, this Nicholson 49. This is only the second one of these I've ever bought as a woodworker. They last forever. Not forever, but they last a long time. And you can see how nice that cuts even in this really, really hard and coarse wood. Okay, that's close enough for now. So I'm gonna sand this, and then I'm gonna start paring this down with the file and the belt sander. And like I said, this is gonna be pretty skinny up here because it has to pass through this narrowest point. And then I wanna lock it down somewhere right around down in here, where I want the taper to come up and lock in the bottom. Let me sand this guy first.